to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year, a show that does for 2012 exactly what the Mayans said would happen. The rules are simple. Each team member or tribute must leave their home district, travel to the capital, and fight to the death with their weapon of choice. Hang on, sorry, I'm thinking of Hunger Games. What we're doing is a pub quiz. Let's meet our teams. Our first guests are blessed with being incredible writers, actors, and comedians. But do they brag about it? Yes, constantly. It's Jack Whitehall and James Corden. Next up, this year, Jonathan asked to be sat with a young, hot, sexy blonde, and we gave him exactly what he asked for. It's Jonathan Ross and Russell Howard. And finally, it's the smart, sexy and sporty Gabby Logan, and next to her, the nervous, sweaty and intimidated Richard Iwadi. So, Jack, James, you're looking...
As we should.
No. It's a black tie
black
event.
Tie event.
It's a
black That's tie what we were event. Invited to.
So we're not the ones that look dicks here.
Yeah.
Jack, you've had a good year. King of comedy this year.
Yes.
Come on, king of comedy. Yes. James, now, you've had an incredible year. You spent a lot of it in New York winning Tony Awards.
Oh, just one. It wasn't clear. Yeah. Yes.
And then another thing happened in 2012. James got married.
Yeah.
Come on. You've had a brilliant year. Russell and Jonathan, presumably you fancy your chances this evening, right?
We are here to win. And I don't see anyone here who can really stand in our way, I'll be honest with you.
Well, Russell, no, you know everything that's happened in the way of good news, but if anything bad, there's a question on that.
Everything bad, yeah. I know all the good stuff that happened this year.
Look how muscular Russell has become. What? He's like Madonna's dream date now. Look at that. Although she wouldn't know whether to sleep with him or adopt him. Magnificent specimen.
You have got the guns now. You've
I'm
got
probably
the guns.
The wrong colour for Madonna to adopt, I would have thought.
Yeah, you don't look fair trade.
Yeah, yeah.
Jonathan, now, last year, you spent the whole year writing comic books. Anything more geeky this year?
Well, yeah, I've made a game. I've been working on an iPad game, an iPhone game, with my son and various other people. We have a game out.
What's the game called?
It's called Catcha Aliens.
Catcha Aliens. Can I just confirm?
No, it's not called Catcha Catch. It's called Catcha Aliens.
Is it like Mexican?
Yeah. No, like, it's not Mexican. But there are some cactus people who run away from you and they do shout Hasta la Fuego.
That's Mexican!
It's not a Mexican game.
Yeah, well, it clearly is. Jonathan has created a game for the Mexican people
catching
aliens and they go, come on, vamanos! And there's cactuses. Unfortunately, it's great, but don't try and download it because you can only get it in Mexico. That's what you're trying to say, right?
I'm going to ban it in Mexico just to prove a point to you.
It's available for 50 pesos.
So, Gabby, presumably you've had an incredible year, have you?
Highlight of which was probably the Olympic Games.
Well, you were all over the Olympic Games. You were there every night.
Loved it. Yeah, it was amazing. Not without its moments, but, you know, generally, I loved it.
Richard, you've had an incredible year as well. You went to Hollywood and starred in a film with Ben Stiller.
I didn't. I went to Atlanta and did one of the least well-regarded films of all time. And then spent a lot of time filming something in an underground gun range in Wokingham. This is going to be an opportunity for me to catch up.
So did you not see any of the Olympics?
No.
Did you see MasterChef?
No.
Did you see the Great British Bake Off?
No.
Take me out?
Take me out, I make time for take me out.
Right, the first round is all about the biggest news headlines of the year. Let's remind ourselves of what happened. In 2012, we had the wettest summer on record, thanks to 50 Shades of Grey. Britain went back into recession, so it's a great relief that we didn't piss all our money away on a giant sports day and a big party for an old lady. Bob Diamond resigned from Barclays after the LIBOR rigging scandal. It's the worst thing to happen to British banking since the Halifax ad, where the staff had their own radio show. Of course, it wouldn't be a quiz without questions. Eyes down, everyone. Round one. OK. All about the headlines of the year. OK, the Levinson Inquiry revealed that David Cameron was regularly texting Rebecca Brooks. But what was he talking about when he wrote, it was fast, unpredictable, hard to control, but fun? Jack looks quietly confident over there.
Quietly, loudly on the face. Very good.
You know what, I like looking down there because this is what quiz shows were like on TV in the 50s.
It does, yeah, it looks like Ask the Family. Well. Okay. If you've seen the Big Fat Quiz before, you'll know that every year the children of Mitchell Brook Primary School in Neasden put on an unconventional school play for us. What news story are they acting out here? Take a look.
Been in charge for a long time.
Here's the ball to say thank you.
Yes!
Congratulations, Mum!
Thank you.
I'm cold.
I'm wet.
Let's go.
I've written a song for you.
La la la, sing sing sing. La la la, sing sing sing.
Obla dee, obla da.
So what news story were they talking about there? For our next question, it's over to Gerard Butler.
Hi, Jimmy. So my question is, back in January, politicians like David Cameron, Ed Balls, David Miliband were falling over themselves to declare their love for hot-baked snacks. But can the teams tell me why?
Well, sorry, I didn't hear a word of that. I was just lost in his eyes.
He should be a politician. As soon as he started putting it, hey, Jimmy, you think if he wanted to raise taxes, you'd go with it. Well, not you personally, but I mean, if he did, people would, wouldn't they?
Yeah, he's a stunning looking man.
He's got an amazing voice. That voice is beautiful.
Oh, beautiful. Yeah. What a beautiful
That's like
man.
Someone holding your head down and making love to your ear wearing a condom made of velvet.
In the US election campaign, what incident led to the formation of the campaign group Dogs Against Romney?
Oh, we're saying what incident? Okay.
Yeah. Wow. So, in the US election campaign, which incident led to the formation of the campaign group Dogs Against Romney? And to finish the round off in an appropriately Gangnam style, here's K-pop superstar Psy.
Yes.
Hello, Jimmy. My video for Gangnam Style became a worldwide sensation this year after over 700 million people watched it on YouTube. But what did Spanish pensioner Cecilia Jimenez do this year to earn international fame?
Is that not me 2 years ago? Yeah. Okay, so Sai wants to know how Spanish pensioner Cecilia Jimenez found international notoriety. All right, so should we go straight to the answers?
Yeah.
We've got the correct answers as well, Jimmy Carr. So
we have 5 points in the bag, I think you'll find.
Yes, sir.
Well done, you. OK. I asked you what David Cameron was referring to when he texted Rebecca Brooks saying it was fast, unpredictable, hard to control, but fun. What did you put?
E.
Wouldn't that be a lovely image, though? Cameron just off his box on E. Wouldn't that be wonderful?
OK, Russell, Jonathan, what have you got?
We went for his prostate exam.
Yeah. Have you had one, Jimmy?
I had. I'll tell you what's embarrassing when you get an erection during a prostate exam and they realise you're not a real doctor. Richard and Gabby, you're our last hope on this question.
We went for a horse.
Horse?
Well, ketamine. Yeah,
yes.
Nice.
That's it.
So you've got it, Logan.
Actually, second, that's
ketamine.
Why didn't we think of that?
Yeah, the old cat. Love it.
Yo, that's so hard. Fuckers want to fire me.
Okay, well, I can tell you, you are absolutely right. He was talking about riding one of Brooks's horses. Did they get the points? OK, we saw the children of Mitchell Brook Primary School performing a school play. What was it about?
The Queen kept her job in a recession.
She looked so bored, though, didn't she, through the entire Jubilee? Every time it cut away, she just like someone shat in her handbag. It's just like, or she looks either bored or like she's kind of just daydreaming. She has that lovely look about it.
I wonder if I lick the back of my head, whether it tastes like a stamp.
But she's...
Lick it, Philip.
You know, she's got that look.
Lick it, Philip. You can't say lick it, Philip, about the Queen.
I have a theory. She didn't sit down for the entirety of that thing, and the people were talking about that. It was the day after the night of her anniversary, and Prince Philip woke up with a urinary infection.
Russell, Jonathan, what did you get for this?
We thought that was Danny Boyle's first attempt at the opening ceremony. We thought maybe he was just going to do it with the kids and go for the cute factor.
Richard and Gabby, what have you got?
Jubilee celebration.
That's right. There's nothing more subversive than sincerity, Jim.
Gerard Butler asked why politicians were falling over themselves to declare their love for hot pastry snacks.
It's to keep Scotland from going solo. They want to break away from the band and, you know, do their own thing.
Nice.
Well, we're trying to keep them.
A lot of people are calling that independence rather than going solo.
Essentially, what it is going solo. And if they do go solo, it's only going to be a matter of time before they do a Robbie Williams and come back. Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
Okay, so what did you put?
We put pasty tax.
Pasty.
I didn't
know
what
I'm guessing that was more Russell's answer than yours.
I didn't know what he meant by it.
People were furious. There was a pasty march. Did you? You
wouldn't have, pasty march?
You'd have loved it, Richard. You didn't see it.
Yeah, I didn't.
It was the unhealthiest march you've ever seen in your life.
Was it a march or a wheezy shuffle?
It was a chubby conga. It was fantastic.
The pasty. And what did you get, Gabby and Richard?
Richard actually knew this one.
Richard knew this one.
Yeah.
Hang on a second.
All right. There's a lot of hostility, but fine. And I'm not allowed access to the pen, which is I'm behind.
Next round, what is yours?
I don't know that that's wise.
So what did you put?
Tax on Cornish pasty.
Yes. Well, I can tell you, you're both right. It was the result of the proposed pasty tax, on which the government later did a U-turn. Okay. I asked you what led to the formation of the campaign group Dogs Against Romney. What did you put?
We put that he slagged off the loose women.
Okay, so you've gone for loose women. Russell and Jonathan.
He strapped his hound to a car. That's what he did.
He did what? Strapped his dog. A beautiful phrase.
Hound. Yeah. Yes, it's nice, isn't it?
He attached his dog to the roof of his car for a 10-hour car journey. And
so I was slightly mesmerised when you did that. We got the full gun show.
It was amazing.
And he said his excuse.
It's all embarrassed now.
His excuse was.
You can't wear that T-shirt, give us a slight glimpse at what the gun show looks like, and never let us get a full glimpse.
Let's just get it out of the way. Just show everyone what they want to see, and then we can move on. Come on, let's see the right arm first.
Who wants it?
I'll tell you what's happening now, right? So this is happening now on telly, but I'm imagining myself at home with my family, with my dad sat there going, fucking don't. And my mum,
go on, do it for the girls.
And my granddad just going, kill me. So I'm not going to do it.
You'll notice. We didn't participate in what was... That was bullying.
Exactly.
Let's call it out. I'm not going to look at them. It was bullying. OK?
I don't see how it's bullying to say, can we have a look at your impressive biceps, please?
You know what you did. I am very anti-bullying. I bought one of those anti-bullying charity wristbands.
I let someone down in school over a similar incident when I was 8, and I'm fucked if I'm letting this happen.
Hey, Rich. Because he didn't want to see him.
A consensual gun show.
A consensual gun show.
We're trying to get close. This show's getting out of hand. Tell me what happened to the car.
So he tied a dog to his car for a 10-hour car journey, and when people got upset, he said, "My dog likes fresh air." That was his excuse.
Okay, what did you guys go for?
We went for the same thing.
I can tell you that you're absolutely right. He strapped his dog to the roof of his car. But also, this is the interesting detail, while the dog had diarrhoea.
Oh.
So if you're in the car behind, that's not a pleasant trip, is it?
Own car, because that rear wiper's going to be working overtime.
Finally, Si asked you how Spanish pensioner Cecilia Jimenez found international notoriety. Did anyone know?
Harry Styles, Wayne Rooney and Caroline Flack. She did the perfect trio. Most people have only ever had one of them individually. The majority of Britain. But she's the only one to have brought them all together.
How do we know, you may ask? I was on the camera, he was on the boom.
I can tell you that is not the exact right
bullshit
answer.
Bullshit!
It's not exactly...
Bullshit!
It's not what I've done to the car, James. I can't give it to you. Russell,
bullshit!
Jonathan.
She'd date Harry Styles.
I can confirm.
Cecilia Jimenez.
I can confirm that Harry Styles. If you're watching this, Harry, this is not a woman that you dated this year. Well, what did you put for this, Richard?
Again, I ceded
Stop
control.
Stop pressing the button. This was yours.
No, you said that, and I went, yeah.
Yeah.
Is it right?
Well, tell us what you put.
Renovate a fresco.
That is the right... Well, that's the right answer. Okay. Let's have a look at the original painting. It's a beautiful old fresco, but you can see it needed work there, yes?
Yeah.
Yep. So good.
And then she did the renovation. And we can see those...
Maybe that's how he got his name. People looked at him and went, Jesus Christ!
Maybe she's Banksy.
Well, we don't know.
No.
I can't say that she definitely isn't. I can tell you, though, she did not sleep with Harry Styles, so you don't get a point, you don't get a point. You get a point, then.
Yay!
Yeah.
So, at the end of the first round, let's have a little look at the scores. Jack and James have 1 point. Russell and Jonathan have 2 points. Richard Iwadi and Gabby Logan are ahead with 5 points. Nice. We're going to take a short break. See you in a bit. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz. This next round is all about sport, and what an amazing year for sport it's been. Chelsea won the Champions League after a thrilling penalty shootout. It's the most explosive climax I've seen since the end of that Talisa video. Andy Murray won the US Open. He's not only Scotland's most successful sportsman, he's also one of only 3 men in Scotland who can climb a flight of stairs without calling an ambulance. Of course, the sporting year was dominated by the Olympic and Paralympic Games. Let's remind ourselves what happened.
He's so up to speed. He's got sport down.
Okay. All right, so first up, the incredible Usain Bolt.
Usain.
Hi, Jimmy. Is Usain Bolt the fastest man in the world? And you know when I win, I love to celebrate. After the 200-meter goal that I won in London 2012, I celebrated by indulging in an artistic streak. What did I do?
He's unbelievably cool, isn't he?
Yeah, he's pretty much the man.
Brilliant.
Oh, is Richard answering?
He's got the pen.
Richard's doing the whole round. You've given Richard the pen.
We're kind of ironic like that.
Yeah, I don't know. I think there's a difference between irony and just a bad idea.
Okay.
Okay. Next question. Boris Johnson was ever present at the Olympics, but what unusual turn of phrase did he use to describe the women's beach volleyball teams?
Oh.
You're looking for an adjective.
Yes, a descriptive word, yes.
Okay, thank you.
Well, a phrase rather than a word.
Okay, great.
Okay.
We win, though, and I think I know the reason why. Because it was meant to be beach volleyball, but if you look at that beach, that is like no beach I've ever seen in the British Isles.
No.
They should have made it more British beach.
Yeah.
Pebbles, used condoms.
Capri Suns.
Capri Suns, couple of needles, maybe a tramp shouting at some seagulls. Give us home advantage. Yeah.
Next question. It's over to diving superstar Tom Daly.
Oh, Tom.
Hi, Jimmy. Tom Daly here. Now, us divers are given a separate pool to the swimmers, and that's probably a good thing, given what Michael Phelps admitted during the Olympic Games. But can your teams tell me what it was?
So, Tom wants to know, what did Michael Phelps confess to doing?
Don't be obvious, Jack.
What?
I'm just being right, Gabby.
That's a curveball. Sneaky play from Logan there.
Very sneaky play.
I'm going to need extra time for being dyslexic as well, Jimmy, by the way, at the end of this. I'll stay around for 20 minutes afterwards. Because that doesn't even... Those aren't even words. There's a comma just floating in midair.
Could be an apostrophe, Dave.
Oh, yes, that's what it is. It's from the bottom.
Yeah. All right, next question. After being presented with a bronze medal, what was American rower Henrik Rummel forced to deny?
Yes.
Oh, I know. Yeah.
So I just used that one word.
Cool. I don't even know how to spell this word. Is that right, Richard? Is that how you spell it?
You don't know how to spell that word?
Yeah.
If that's what it is,
that is how you spell it.
OK. And for our final question, it's over to Jessica Ennis. Jessica Ennis, everyone.
Hi, Jimmy. Now, I know you've all been glued to the Olympics this year, so this question should be a breeze. Can your teams name all the seven events within the heptathlon?
Shit.
Come on.
Now, this, for you guys, is more of a handwriting challenge.
I'm not even going to challenge whatever he says. Go.
No, come on, Gabby, you should know these. OK. Pens down. You ready?
Yeah.
OK. And Usain Bolt wanted to know how he celebrated winning the 200 metres. Did anyone remember?
Yes. How does anyone celebrate any achievement? Gordon, fire away.
TFI Fridays, big table.
Correct.
Ranch sharing platter.
He's so right.
We're talking filled, like, potato
wedges,
skins.
Wings, skins, bites, dips, cocktail. Thank you. Waiters come over, crazy song, fucking big cake. Go on.
What did you get for this, Russell and Jonathan?
I think he celebrated by doing the Swedish volleyball team. Because I saw photographs, not explicit photographs, but I saw photographs of him with them, and they looked like they were having a nice time. He looked like he was having a nice time. I think it was just a mutual thing.
Well, I can tell you that after the 100 metres, he did tweet at 3 o'clock in the morning a picture of himself with the Swedish handball team.
Oh, so
this is the picture. The question was after the 200 metres, how did
he
celebrate?
Well, he moved up to the volleyball team.
Yes.
He's working his way through all the Swedish lady units.
OK, what did you get for this, Richard and Gabby, the split personality team?
You said artistic, so I put tapestry.
You think he celebrated by doing a tapestry?
Did he?
No, he did not do a tapestry.
OK, then I was
wrong.
That would
be a beautiful thing, wouldn't it? And imagine how quickly you'd finish it.
With Usain Bolt, one thing I think, an idea, right? You know that horse Frankel, fastest racehorse in the world? It's retired now and it's been put out to stud. Its jizz is going at 100 grand a pop. Usain Bolt, fastest man on the planet. They should start milking that man's penis and selling stuff off because he could rake it in. My sister, for example, her boyfriend Archie, completely physically inept. I would pay good money to have him tup her. See my sister. Molly, if you're watching, I'm going to get it sorted.
Do you plan to race your nephew?
I think Frankel's sperm is more like 2 million.
2 million?
Yeah,
that, for that money, it must be delicious.
OK, Gabby.
Yes.
Gabby, what was your answer?
I put photography.
Photography. Mm. That is the right answer. When Usain Bolt won the 200 metres, what he did is he stole a camera from one of the photographers and he started taking pictures.
When you say stole it, he didn't actually run off with it, did he?
Well, if he had, he would have got away with it. He's bloody quick. We got the photos here. Just took some lovely photos.
He should have put it on Instagram, made it all sepia, made it like the original London Olympics.
OK, I asked you what choice turn of phrase did Boris Johnson use to describe the women's beach volleyball teams?
Rancid.
Gabby, what did you get?
I said wet beasts.
Wet beasts. James and Jack.
We've got jolly volley volleyball. Did you see the bloody jolly volley volleyball?
Did you see the bloody jolly
volleyball?
Absolutely
bloody brilliant. I went down and watched the bloody jolly volley volleyball.
Brilliant. OK, Russell, Jonathan, what have you got?
This is Russell, but because it's like sort of porn for cowards, isn't it, the beach volleyball?
Starter porn.
I know the answer. He said that they were glistening like wet otters. Like, only he could say that and it sounds lovely. Like, if you say that in a Cockney accent, that sounds horrendous, doesn't it? You're glistening like a wet otter. Boris, glistening like a wet otter!
Well, that is exactly his words. That's exactly what he said.
Glistening like a wet otter.
Yeah. Tom Daley asked you what Michael Phelps confessed to doing. What do you think it was?
It's on his period.
On his period.
Is he trying to get out of one of the races?
Is
the only way you get out
it's
of swimming.
It's the only way you can get out of swimming. It's the only way you period. Get out. So he did it. He had a note from his mum saying he was on his period, and then he got off one of the swimming races.
Well, it's a great answer, but weirdly, that is not right.
Bullshit.
Bullshit.
Russell, Jonathan, what did you put?
We thought he must have, the obvious, that he'd peed in the water.
Nice. What did you get for this?
OK. That they sanctify the water and he's an agnostic. It's not like he's completely uncomfortable with it, but he just doesn't want it forced on him.
Gabby, over to you for this.
I put pee.
I can tell you that's exactly the right answer. He yeah. admitted that he peed in the pool.
Yeah, fair enough. There you
go. I wonder. Okay, I asked you what American rower Henrik Rummel was forced to deny. What did you think?
Did he put his medal on eBay?
Richard, Gabby, what did you put?
That he'd had a breast reduction.
Oh, it's such a good answer. I'm afraid it's not the right answer. Oh. He did not have a...
But he did say, didn't he, that he didn't have an erection.
Was that the word you didn't know how to spell?
Yeah, I didn't know whether it was two R's or not.
I don't know where to go with that.
What have you got for this, Russell, Jonathan?
Jonathan?
We thought he got an erection. We thought it was on display.
Well, I can tell you that you guys are right. He was forced to deny having an erection whilst receiving his bronze medal. Let's have a look. Judge for yourselves.
See, there you go.
Wow.
It's not like he's hanging the medal off it.
Can you imagine what that photo would look like if he got a gold?
What's the worst place you've ever had an erection, Jimmy?
I would say in... I forget her name. Jessica Ennis wanted to know the seven events that comprise the heptathlon. What did you all get?
Throwing, chucking, running, fast running, really fast running, jumping, and running and jumping over stuff.
We really struggled on this.
We went with egg and spoon, sack race,
cage fight,
bake off,
cage fight,
belly dance, 400 metres and javelin.
I mean, she's a national treasure, Jessica Ennis.
Yeah, she's amazing, but I can't remember what she did. I just remember when I look at her, I feel good.
OK, Richard, seven events.
OK, calligraphy, table tennis.
Calligraphy.
Trampolining, that was.
Irony. Go-kart and two others.
Gabby, what do you think? What are your seven?
100 hurdles.
Yes, correct.
200 metres.
200 metres, yes, correct.
800 metres.
Yes.
High jump.
Yes.
Long jump.
Yes.
Javelin.
Yeah.
I've just realised I've written hurdles twice.
I didn't want to embarrass you, Gary. I mean...
I think it's shot
fucking dead weight. I mean...
It is shot put, yeah. So, Gabby, you get a point there. I'm afraid you guys do not get points.
I like how it's now just Gabby.
Because Gabby is like sports presenter, so this is like playing. This is her forte.
You guys don't do a show called A League of Their Own, do you?
Oh yeah.
I mean, both of you, right? Yeah. You jack off.
Shit.
Right, now it's time for the part of the show where we meet a mystery guest.
Ooh.
Who made the news this year? All you have to do is work out who they are and how they made the news. You can only ask yes or no questions. Ladies and gentlemen, our mystery guest.
Very nice to see you.
Very well indeed. Obviously, I'm not going to introduce you. That would defeat the whole purpose. You can ask him yes or no questions. He made the news this year.
Where did you get that shirt?
Very good question. Do you know what? I was thinking I could...
Yes or no answers. Yes or no. Don't engage with them. They will fool you.
No, I haven't got a shirt.
Have you been on telly before?
Yes.
Were you anything to do with the Olympics?
Yes.
Are you an athlete?
No.
Oh, but that wasn't a no. That was like a no.
Are you a coach?
No.
Are you a stuntman?
Yes.
Ah.
Oh. Yes. If you think you've got it, write it down, because otherwise you'll just give it away to the others.
That.
Have you got an answer for this?
I think so.
You think you know? Okay, you think you know?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
James and Jack are just writing down.
Okay,
we've got it. We got it. Yeah,
okay.
We got it.
So, who do you think this man is?
He's Emily Sander.
You're Emily Sander.
You are. He's seen you do the singing.
I love your new song with Labyrinth.
Oh, it's so good.
Thank you. Russell, Jonathan?
He jumped out the helicopter with the Queen.
You're Daniel Craig!
Okay,
and what did you get, Richard? Gabby? Go
we
on.
We think the person that looked like the Queen that jumped out the helicopter was, in fact, you.
Yep, my name is Gary Connery, and I stunt doubled for the Queen jumping out of the helicopter.
Excellent. There he is. Let's have a quick look at you as the Queen. There he is. I love the fact you put on a little bit of makeup there. You thought, well, they might do a close-up.
Was it the most amazing feeling coming over the stadium and just thinking, I'm going to jump out of the telly and just fly into that stadium now with the whole world watching?
It was amazing. In truth, you know, it was one of those things that I don't think you're ever going to forget. But when you're in that moment, obviously what you're doing is just focusing very much on the job at hand.
How amazing was it to wake up with Prince Philip the next morning?
Well, you know, you are officially now a Bond girl.
Yes, I do.
Wow, that's incredible. And you're not on the bottom of my list, by the way.
That's very sweet of you to say so.
You sound like David Beckham. Shut your eyes. Shut your eyes.
Shut your eyes, OK. Your eyes.
And then say, Victoria, just go get my socks out the wash, OK? And then close your eyes.
All right, close your eyes.
Victoria, just go and get my socks out the wash.
Wow, yeah.
Surely you could have come up with something better than that. Well, that's really good. I need to say to Victoria.
OK, well, let's take a quick look at what that's done to the scores. Jack and James have 1 point. Russell and Jonathan have 5 points. Richard and Gabby, 10 points. Wow. Time for another quick break, but one more time, a big hand for Gary Connery, the Queen. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz. This next round is all about the famous faces who made 2012 what it was. David Cameron was accused of spending too much time chillaxing this year. The word chillaxing is a composite of chilling and relaxing, and it's used mainly by funts and consoles. Kim Jong-un became the leader of North Korea. Critics of the new leader have said, ah, please stop torturing me. And in July, I made headlines, which was great news if there's no such thing as bad publicity. I tell you what, that's when you know you're in trouble. When the Prime Minister of the country that you live in breaks off from the G20 summit in Mexico, he's in a meeting with Barack Obama, the most important man in the world, and he says, excuse me, Barack, I've got something very important I need to deal with right now. Jimmy Carr is a dick. Right, time for some more questions. I wasn't the only one embroiled in a tax scandal this year. So was this dog. But how?
He specifically came out of the meeting just to say you're a dick.
Yeah.
He could have said that any time, though.
It looks like he's about to get strapped onto Mitt Romney's car. Yeah.
Time for another guest question. This time it's from the man who fell to earth. It's stuntman and daredevil, Felix Baumgartner.
Hi, Jimmy. I had a pretty quiet year, apart from that time when millions of people watched me break the sound barrier when I jumped from space. But what were my last words before I took the plunge?
Yeah, Felix Baumgartner wanted to know what his last words were before he fell from space. Was it, I like Def Leppard and pretty girls?
Oh, he fell out of a big thing, but he wasn't dressed as the Queen, was he? That's what I will
say. No, he was not, Jonathan. So what did Felix say before he jumped out of the plane? Next question. Anthony Worrell Thompson was caught stealing from his local Tesco's. Yeah. Can you name 3 items he stole?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Anthony Worrell Thompson owns a pub hotel in the countryside in which I lost my virginity.
Wow.
Not to him. Not to him. to a lady, a woman. Isn't that lovely?
That is absolutely lovely.
I look at him, I think of the happiest night of my life and the worst of hers.
But that shows you how wonderfully posh you are, that you lost your virginity in an award-winning restaurant.
Rather than in a bush like the rest of us.
Where did you lose yours?
Underneath the Severn Bridge at an army camp.
Those soldiers were gentle.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. But it was brutal, because you could hear, go on, mate. I'm trying to make love.
OK, Prince Harry enlivened the summer no end when photos surfaced of his nude antics in Vegas. But what game was he said to have been playing at the time?
Oh, I know this.
Well, what game was he playing when nude photos were taken of him?
Black Ops 2.
And finally, here's a picture of journalist Samantha Brick. She wrote at length this year about how she suffers from a terrible, life-ruining affliction. I'd like to know, what is it? Yeah. What life-ruining affliction does she suffer from?
Okay,
without further ado, here are the answers. Okay, I asked you how this dog was involved in a tax scandal. Did anyone get this?
Does it own Starbucks?
Oh. Oh, no, it's the Churchill dog, isn't it? Were they embroiled in it?
No.
Oh, no, 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 no.
Nice. What did you get, Russell, Jonathan?
We assumed he might be your accountant, which would explain why you took such fucking bad advice.
That is not my accountant.
Well, you might be better off going with him next time.
It was Harry Redknapp.
Harry Redknapp claimed that the dog was either earning money or had some of the money offshore offshore.
He had an account set up in the dog's name. Yeah. Like Rosie or something.
That is exactly right. What did you get, Richard and Gabby?
He bought a lukewarm pasty, I put.
Well, let's go maybe with Gabby's answer, Gabby.
Harry Redknapp's dog, Rosie, because Rosie had an offshore account in her name, didn't she?
In his name, yeah. I can tell you that it's Harry Redknapp's dog, Rosie, and it was revealed during the Redknapp's trial for tax evasion he'd opened a bank account in her name. I also should say Harry Redknapp was found entirely innocent on all charges, and Rosie was found to be a good girl. Yes, you are.
In that photo, they look like novelty slippers, though.
He looks like a giant spaniel with those ears.
This photo just keeps on giving. He totally does. Okay, the man who fell to earth, Felix Baumgartner, asked you for the last words he said before jumping out of the plane. What did you put?
He said that he shouted, "It's pronounced Baumgartner!"
What do you think?
He said, "I'm coming home," but you couldn't hear him say home. So it really changed.
We don't know.
You don't know?
He said, "I've betrayed everyone I care about."
Have a look at him in action.
That could be anyone.
No man has fallen further other than Jimmy Savile this year.
I asked you what Anthony Worrell Thompson stole from his local Tesco's. What did you get?
We know, Jimmy, that if you say stuff, if you mention products that you might like on the television, people might send things to you.
Clever.
We think he maybe stole a case of Bollinger champagne.
Six. And the big ones as well.
The big Magnums. And a pyramid of Ferrero Rochers.
Multi-tiered, not the small ones.
And some Caniston Wants.
The pills and the cream.
OK, that is not exactly the right answer. Russell, Jonathan, what did you get?
Cheese, onions and Jamie's 15-minute meals. That's what he got. He wanted to go home and cook it up. But it's like a recipe that says, take onions, take cheese. He'd had a drink, he just followed it directly.
What did you put for this?
Richard?
Spam, John Bishop DVD. I haven't seen it. I like him. And birthday candles. I'm really
birthday
upset.
Candles!
Have you had a Spam birthday cake?
Is that a public school thing?
That's what we call it.
Oh, Gabby, a little bit of sense from you.
We went with cheese as well.
Cheese, yeah.
And wine. And the most extraordinary thing of all, coleslaw.
That is mental.
Crazy.
He nicked cheese, bread, onions and two packs of discounted coleslaw. So you get a point, you get a point, you do not get a point. But you may get some Bollinger, so cheer up. Next up, what game was Prince Harry said to have been playing when he was photographed naked in Vegas?
It's a Royal Knockout.
Come on, girls, let's play It's a Royal Knockout.
That is a public school thing.
Russell?
Teabag the Swan.
Teabag the Swan?
Teabag the Swan. Teabag the Swan and strip billiards. He did a bit of both. If I was a multimillionaire single prince, there'd never be a photo of me with my clothes on.
Yeah.
I'd smash my way through Europe like the Black Death.
What have you guys got?
I went for Donkey Kong.
Strip pool? Strip snooker?
Strip pool? Well, I'll give you a point and I'll give you a point. That's right, it was strip billiards. Finally, from what life-ruining affliction does journalist Samantha Brick suffer?
Oh. She is the most beautiful woman in the world.
Yeah.
And that is an affliction.
She's someone else.
It makes you think, though, that a mirror must be pissed. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who is you? You're fucking lovely.
Richard thinks something else, but who knows? Richard could be right.
What did you... What
Does
did you
she think she's a sailor?
Gabby, you've put...
I did it in French.
OK.
Le Belle Portois.
Oh, nice.
Wow. That's fancy, so schmancy. That's just getting ridiculous now. You're so confident you know the answer, you're now writing it in a second language.
I just thought we might get a bonus point.
Well, you don't get a bonus point, but you do get a point because, yes, Samantha Brick is too beautiful. I'm tall, slim, blonde, and so often I'm told a good-looking woman. I know how lucky I am, but there are downsides to being pretty. The main one being that other women hate me for no other reason than my lovely looks.
Me and Brick are very similar. We're just too good looking.
Do you know your affliction can be dealt with by a professional?
Yeah.
It's an optician. OK, let's have a quick check on the scores. I can tell you that Jack and James have 2 points.
Yes!
Yeah, oh yeah. Rocking it. OK, Russell and Jonathan have 10 points. Richard and Gabby have 14 points, way out in the lead. Time for some ads now, but don't go away. There's still plenty more Big Fat Quiz action to come. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz. This next round is all about the year in music. Russian punk act Pussy Riot were jailed for protesting against Vladimir Putin. Of course, Pussy Riot is a mistranslation of their Russian name, more accurate translation of which would be vagina argument or muff scuffle. Chris Moyles quit the Radio 1 breakfast show, having presented it since 2004. Chris left an indelible mark on Radio 1. It's a combination of gravy, mayonnaise and ketchup that the cleaners just cannot shift. Adele recorded the new Bond theme. I'm not saying they're predictable, but the same thing happens in every single Bond film. He says, my name's Bond, James Bond, and I get an erection. OK, ready for some more questions? First up, it's over to Channel 4's Newsmeister General, Jon Snow, with a special report on one of this year's biggest songs. But which one is it? Over to you, John.
A 26-year-old Canadian woman has been arrested for harassment after accosting a man she had just met and encouraging him to contact her by telephone. A key witness said that she made salacious remarks regarding the man's ripped jeans, noting that his skin was showing. She went on to offer pennies, dimes, and her soul in exchange for a kiss and a wish, then informed the man that she had missed him so, so bad prior to knowing him. The woman denied having mental health issues, but admitted to police that her actions could be construed as crazy.
Surely someone has just flicked over to Channel 4 as that came on. That must be an amazing... What's going on?
But it's disconcerting. Hearing him talk about music, it's like having Bruce Forsyth explain Angry Birds to you or something. It doesn't go together.
OK, next question. After seeking counselling from a Jamaican high priest, and who doesn't, what did Snoop Dogg do this year?
A Jamaican high priest is just a priest. They're all high.
He's a massive fan of Coronation Street. He wants to build a Rover's Return in LA.
Well, how high do you have to be before you make that decision?
Yeah. Okay. I like bitches and I like hoes, but not as much as I like Ken Barlow.
Okay, so time for another guest question from none other than pop princess Kylie Minogue.
Kylie, oh yeah.
Hi, Jimmy. This year, fellow songstress Sarah Brightman announced that she was going to be the first singer to do what?
Okay, so Sarah Brightman announced this year she was going to have an amazing first. What was it going to be? Susan Boyle released her fourth album this year, Standing Ovation, the greatest love songs from the stage. But what ill-judged Twitter hashtag were fans encouraged to use to promote the record?
Such a lovely noise when everyone is it. I remember that.
And for our final question, it's over to none other than Cheryl Cole.
Hi, everyone. Now, back in January, Beyoncé gave birth, but I was wondering if any of you could tell me what her and Jay-Z named their first baby daughter.
Yeah. Okay.
Hello.
There's my man.
Thank you so much. Sorry.
Thank you.
It's a long show, Jimmy, so we ordered some food. Is that okay?
Would you
you mean you ordered food?
We ordered food in.
How did you order? What do you mean you ordered food? Yeah.
Think about your fellow contestants.
We ordered some food. No, because you mocked our suits.
you actually ordered food in?
Yeah.
Oh, God. That is the best piece of planning I've ever seen.
If anyone tunes in and sees this, they're going to think Downton Abbey's gone very down market.
That's really not fair. It looks so good.
Yeah, you're not even sharing.
Do you know what you need to do?
No.
Get over it.
Oh, classic Gordon. OK, Jon Snow reported on one of the biggest songs of the year. Did anyone work out what it was?
It was Carly Rae Jepsen, Call Me Maybe.
OK, did you... Russell, Jonathan?
We got the same.
OK, and Richard, Gabby?
Call Me Baby, Maybe.
Call Me Baby, yeah. Yeah, and you got...
Came into my life, I miss you so bad, so bad,
It's like a couple of fucking lords have rocked up to pizza.
Let's have a listen.
So call me baby. Hey, I just need you.
It was tough being underground, but then there were times, like now, when I'm pleased I was.
Did you not love that song? It's the best song that's ever been written.
I have seen the video, and the video is great because at the end, the guy's bloody gay. I'd not seen a twist like that since Smack My Bitch Up Prodigy.
To be fair, though, if you gave your number out to a girl, pretty girl like that, and then you discovered that she was as annoying as Carly Rae Jepsen, you'd suck a cock to get rid of her.
Jack, you don't have to suck cocks to get rid of people. Just say it's not
working out.
Those
are the rules,
though. You need to leave. I'm late. Every time you leave a room, it's like, ah. Late. I've got another meeting.
Richard, can you please stop neglecting the balls when you do that mime? How difficult is that? How difficult is that?
Don't tell me what to do while I'm sucking your cock, Jim.
All right, it was, of course, Carly Rae Jepsen, Call Me Maybe. OK, next up, I asked you, what did Snoop Dogg do this year after consulting with the Jamaican high priest? Did anyone get this?
Well, we thought the dog thing, and it's something I had done to my dog, we thought he got spayed.
You thought Snoop Dogg got spayed this year?
Yeah, or neutered, whichever way you want to call it.
Jonathan, Russell, what did you get?
I knew he changed his name. I thought it was to Pudsey Bear, but it wasn't. And Russell knew it was a lion. I saw him, he does like a kid's thing, doesn't he? He does like a song for children dressed as the Rastafari lion. The Lion King of Rastafari or something like that?
Yeah, he's now called Snoop Lion.
Snoop Lion.
That is his full name. Richard, Gabby, what did Snoop Dogg do after consulting with the Jamaican high priest?
Yeah, his tax.
Richard, that was me.
You did not do your tax.
Gabby, what did you
do? Same as these guys. Snoop Lion, I think, is the name that he adopted, wasn't it?
That is exactly the right answer. He changed his name to Snoop Lion. So you get a point, you get a point, you do not get a point. OK, Kylie asked you about Sarah Brightman's plans for the future. What did you put?
She's going to become a pirate.
Not like copying DVDs, like actual pirate. a real pirate, like kidnapping old people.
She's just going to go all at it.
What do you think?
I think she's going to visit Andrew Lloyd Webber's home planet.
That is devilishly close.
I think she's going to go grey naturally.
She's going to go grey naturally. And what did you put?
Sing in space.
That is the right answer. Wow.
What?
She's gonna what? Sing in space.
What?
Yeah, Sarah Brightman announced that she's to receive Russian cosmonaut training in order to become the first singer in space. Richard Iowardi, ladies and gentlemen, has got one right. OK, I asked you what unusual Twitter hashtag fans of Susan Boyle were encouraged to use. What did you think?
Susan! loves it in the arse.
James Corden. James Corden, why won't you take this seriously? Jack Whitehall, you will not be allowed to sit with James Corden in the future.
We're not far off the answer. We're not asking and you don't know that she doesn't.
You can't get
Sim, hashtag Sim.
What is it? Tell me, James.
I can't
tell
say
me, James.
It. This is where I do myself in and I forget we're recording this and it's going to be on TV. I just think we're having a great time eating pizza.
You won a Tony Award.
And she clearly loves it in the air.
Okay, what did you go for, Richard, Gabby?
Hashtag be more racist.
To promote her album, you thought was hashtag.
Yeah, it didn't work. That.
No. Well, no, I said unusual, and that would be.
Yeah, it's unusual.
Well, it's certainly unusual. Wrong, I would even say.
You've got a bloody album to sell. You do what you can.
Gabby, what did you put on your side of the board?
Susan, album party. So it looks like Sue's anal bomb party.
Yeah. Telling me that Sue is having an anal bum party and not enjoying it.
Can I just say, it would be great if they are right, though, wouldn't it? Because it was Susan's album party, but if it was Sue's anal bum party and people turned up expecting music and it was just Boyle with a load of lube just going...
It could be.
But all bums, what bums aren't anal? I mean, there's a redundancy within the hashtag.
Yeah. That's true. The redundancy within the hashtag.
And that should be the name of your...
Anusless bum is not a bum, it's a back.
Thank you, Jack.
Correct. And there's a fact.
The answer was, of course, hashtag Sue's anal bum party, which could be misread as Susan album party. Next, Cheryl Cole asked you the name of Beyonce and Jay-Z's baby. What did you all put?
Well, we didn't know if the child was going to be named after, with Jay-Z's second name, or Beyonce's. Oh. So, if it's Beyonce's, we think they call it Nick. So it's Nick Knowles. After the world's greatest DIY expert. And if it's after Jay-Z, they'd call it A2.
Okay, what did you go for, Russell Johnson?
I know the answer, just because I think it's brilliant. She's called Blue Ivy. And the reason why I love that is because she sounds like a northern prostitute.
I'm Blue Ivy. Who wants a hand job?
Do you know what I mean?
Because I know Blue Ivy, that's on the Farrow and Ball paint charm. I think he's just what he wants to paint his bedroom as.
Richard, I notice you've just put an arrow.
Yeah, I've started just putting an arrow towards Gabby's answers because it's really what we go for in the end.
Did I get Carter right? I just imagined Carter.
Blue Ivy Carter. That is the right answer.
You can call your kid whatever you want if you're as cool as Jay-Z. It's like David Beckham. You can call his kid whatever he wants because you're going to get away with it.
It's going to be tough at school.
For a bit.
But no, Jay-Z's your dad and Beyonce's your mum. School is an absolute joy.
Yeah. You're untouchable.
Try going to school if your mum's an assistant social worker and your dad is a Christian book salesman. And you're 4 stone overweight. That, my friend, ain't no holiday.
OK, time now for another quick bonus round. This time it's about the year's movies. I'm going to show you pictures from three of my favourite films this year, all of which have been subtly improved. All I want you to do is name the films. Here we go. So, first one.
You look great.
That's actually from my audition piece for that film. I didn't get the part, but, you know, down to the final two. The next one.
You look like you're enjoying that. You're pretending you're not, but you're having a good time there, Jimmy. Look at that.
I'm having a great time, yeah.
We're going to die hard.
OK, and the final one. There I am.
That's just horrible.
Have you all got three answers?
Yeah.
What have you got?
Hunger Games, Looper, Magic Mike.
Boom.
Hunger Games, Looper, Magic Mike.
You got?
Hunger Games, Looper, Magic Mike.
Let's have a look at how it should have looked. So I was standing in for Jennifer Lawrence in Hunger Games. That's me as Joseph Gordon-Levitt in Looper. And Channing Tatum in Magic Mike. Points all round.
There you go.
So let's have a look and see how that's affected the scores. James and Jack have 6 points. Russell and Jonathan have 17 points. Richard and Gabby still in the lead with 22 points. We're going to take a short break, but don't go away. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of 2012. This next round is all about the year's television. One of the most controversial TV shows this year was Channel 4's Drugs Live, or the Tour de France, as it's better known.
That's a real red wine laugh going on there.
Fuck off, Jonathan.
Britney Spears was a judge on the new series of X Factor in the US. Britney was understandably nervous. The last time she was in a room with that many judges, they were taking her kids away. The Jimmy Savile scandal sent the BBC into meltdown. The organisation hadn't been that badly shaken since Lisa Riley did the Charleston. Let's remind ourselves what we were watching in 2012.
Take it nice and easy.
Trying to help. That's all. We're
doing this together.
Why should we jump against it? Like that.
You hear what I'm saying?
The madness is my swimming pool. I'm at home in that kind of water.
That looks amazing.
Now I want to say something. Doesn't matter.
Fantastic. Okay. Who wants questions? I got questions. You saw the thick of it there in the montage, which, according to the Oxford English Dictionary, gave us the word of the year. What was it?
Fuckity-fuckity-fuckity-fuckity.
Jack and James, whatever you're thinking, it's probably wrong.
So nice that you're not saying that to me.
For our next question, it's over to legendary actor Simon Callow. Simon Callow.
Hi, Jimmy. Poor Prince Charles spent most of this year being overshadowed by his dear old mum, Her Madge, the Queen. So this year, he auditioned live for a new job on Scottish TV. But can the teams tell me what it was?
He sounds like Jack when you're going to be an old man. He's got to get your voice.
That's why you're going to sell it.
The X Factor was won this year by James Arthur. But what was memorable about his post-win interview on Lorraine Kelly's show the following day?
He looks like a girl trying to impersonate Plan B, doesn't he?
That is exactly it. This year, Barack Obama was quoted as saying the following: while Michelle and the girls go and play tennis on Saturday afternoons, I go in the Oval Office, pretend I'm going to work, and then I put on what?
Oh, obviously.
I didn't think what you're writing.
But I imagine they've got cameras in the Oval Office. They must have cameras, so he couldn't use it as a masturbatorium. he can't relax in there like that.
What a lovely term, masturbatorium. You just throw that in like it's an everyday
word.
It's
lovely, isn't it? It is the place where every man has a masturbatorium.
And finally, here's one of our Say What You See puzzles. I'm going to show you a string of pictures that spell out a sentence. Here's an example. So that's James Cordon.
Nice.
So these pictures spell out a TV talking point of the year, but what is it? Have a little look. So that's a big TV talking point of the year.
Is that Gok Wan at the far left?
No, that
Gok Wan at a Christmas party.
That is not Gok Wan.
Who is it?
The first picture there, that's a generic type of person.
Oh, I know what it is.
Okay. Okay, pens down. Pens down, you all ready for this? Okay. So the thick of it gave us the word of the year. What was that word? Jack and James.
Lobsteromanus.
What, sorry?
Lobstrominus, Jimmy. It was lobstrominus.
Lobstrominus. Which
they
means...
gave us the word lobstrominus.
What does the word mean, James?
It doesn't matter what it means, Jack. They gave us the word.
What does it mean, though, out of interest,
lobstrominus.
Though,
the beauty of being lobstrominus is it can be whatever you mean. Oh, this is lobstrominus wine.
What is having an effect?
Did you see the Big Fat Quiz of the Year? I did. It was a bit lobstrominus. It just works.
Russell, Jonathan.
Well, we thought fuckity bye is the actual word. Fuckity says
fuckity
bye on the
phone. Was a phrase they used, but that was not the word of the year according to the Oxford English Dictionary. It was
Omni shambles.
Ah, oh, tits.
Yeah. That is the right answer.
Omni shambles.
So we got Omni
shambles.
OK, so Simon Callow asks you, what job did Prince Charles audition for on live TV? What do you all put?
Taggart.
He's the new Taggart.
Russell, Jonathan?
Based on his looks, we've gone for...
Dobby from Harry Potter.
Oh, it's a good thought,
isn't it? He looks like a house elf, doesn't
he? He looks like a really sweet old house elf.
Why won't Mummy give me some socks?
And Richard and Gabby?
Well, he did... I think it was Camilla as well. They did Weather Report.
You were saying that.
Gabby knows every
Richard knows weather.
You knew that. Well, how did you get the weather report in the bunker?
Every day I'd get an A4 of just the crucial news. So I heard about the tax, I heard about this, and I heard about Cornish pasties.
And the results of Take Me Out.
Take Me Out. I mean, that was just on a live feed. And then I wet.
OK, well, let's have a look.
Well, it's an unsettled picture as we head towards the end of the week. In the west, rain will be lighter and patchier. There will maybe a few drier interludes over Dumfries House in Ayrshire. Aha. There'll be snow for the higher ground of the Highlands and Aberdeenshire. The potential for a few flurries over Balmoral. Who the hell wrote this script?
I love the fact it's his first time he's doing it. He's already bitching about the script.
I asked you what was notable about James Arthur's interview on Lorraine Kelly after winning the X Factor. Did anyone get
it,
this?
We've got it.
Go on, what you got?
Richard's got it.
He committed genocide.
What did you put?
Either he admitted he'd never really experienced love or he threw up on Lorraine.
It's a good thought. What did you guys
say? Okay, this is not going to be a correct answer on your card, and I know it's not written on your card. Lorraine's incredible presence. Because she is phenomenal.
She's not phenomenal. She's not phenomenal. She's lobstrominous.
She is.
And that's worth a point, Jimmy. It might not be the answer on your card, but it's a fact.
That is the confidence of men that have had a bottle of wine each. OK, let's have a look. Let's have a look. Let's treat ourselves.
After the break, now millions of us watched as June's feature meme to be crowned the winner of The X Factor last night. Is he really genuinely sleeping? Oh, God, love him.
So no one got that, no points there. Barack Obama was sneakily doing something in the Oval Office when pretending to work. What was it?
We're embarrassed by what we've written, Jimmy.
Don't want to hear it. We wrote it and we instantly regretted it and we're very sorry for what we've done, so I'm going to stay here till the end of the round. Just carry on, honestly.
Oh, OK. Russell, Jonathan, what have you got?
He was watching Grand Designs. Yeah. He's obsessed with it.
Shit, that's what I put.
Oh, you didn't write that. I've just seen what they've written.
Are you not?
Oh, that, yeah, yeah. It's just...
So you thought Grand Designs, you thought Richard, Gabby?
Richard knew this.
Richard knew this.
I thought he put on Wham and his special mittens.
Special mittens?
Yeah. Like the ones for going out.
See, that's like a lovely anyway. Answer.
That's sort of what you put in a
weird
way.
No, it's not.
It's not.
So Barack Obama put something on in the Oval Office. What did he put on, James?
He put on a condom and had a posh. I'm out, Jimmy, I'm done.
You know that bit at the bottom of the barrel? There's space beneath it.
Okay, so what I can tell you the answer is watching Homeland. He's a huge fan of Homeland. Finally, I showed you a Say What You See question. Did anyone get this?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, go on, what you get?
Finger twat door domino key jungle.
Devilishly close. What did you get, Russell?
Jonathan got it right, I think.
Nadine Dorries went in the jungle. Or in the jungle.
OK, so what have you got? Have you got that, Richard?
Yeah, we used the past participle, though, so...
Because she'd technically been in already.
I don't know.
How does it Nadine Dorries?
Nerd, Dean, Dorries, enters, jungle. So you both get points, you do not get a point.
Yes, thank you.
That's not the
OK, we've got a special treat for you now to ask our next question. It's the three finalists from my favourite show of the year, The Great British Bake Off. It's James, Brendan and John. Tell us everything about how it's been.
Amazing.
It makes you realise just the influence and the power of the programme. You know, we know it's a reality TV programme, but actually it touches people's lives. And the conversations you have with people in the supermarket, the high street, it's extraordinary. So I'm really glad to have been part of it now that I'm aware of it.
You're the sweetest man I've ever met. You're incredible.
That's why he bakes cakes.
It's amazing. He's just so, so
major
lovely.
Ingredient is sugar, dude. If it's coming out your fingertips, you're fine. No one knew about baking until you guys invented it. It's the best show in the world. I want a hug from Brendan because Brendan is the nicest gnome on the planet.
He's the best gnome. One for John and James too. Come on, give Brendan a hug.
Because Brendan should have won, let's be honest. I mean, you know. Come on. Would it have broke your heart to let him take it?
Okay, so has life changed since you won? Has it changed things for you?
Not really me. I'm back to uni. I'm studying to become a doctor, so I'm just.
What are you going to do? Come on.
I'm doing my book. I'm doing writing a recipe book. And I'm going to pastry school as well in January.
What? Pastry school?
Tell me about pastry school.
Yeah, we learn how to make pastry.
Oh. Oh, that's less interesting.
OK, now, did you bring any... You didn't bring any cakes along?
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. We have.
Oh, come on.
Have you brought cakes? Oh, my God, these look amazing cakes. Oh. Such a cake. Let's turn these around.
That's a good did thought. You work
these
together to make these?
Me?
Oh, my gosh.
Are these cakes of everyone? So do you want to go and give them to the people that... Careful. That's mine. Wow, so I've got a cake of my hand. Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay. Look at that. Is that a good likeness? Is that all right?
I want to give this
That's
to
not
Gabby,
bad, is it?
Jimmy, yeah? If we're having pudding, can someone get me some port?
God, this is amazing.
Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
No one have got some. Yeah,
that's good. Oh, my God. Wow. Look at, oh, my God.
I look like the Yorkshire Ripper.
Russell's got the worst one. Look at Russell. Russell's is...
Oh, my God! You're Javier Bardem in Skyfall in that box.
although James, in fairness, my James eyes are wonky.
Can I just point out, James's cake definitely hasn't risen.
Now, I should point out, you guys didn't make these cakes. We got these cakes made because we thought it would be a nice thing for you guys to bring us cakes. Richard, have you tried yours?
Don't touch it. It's voodoo.
Yours appears to be a burglar.
Yeah. I'm not quite angry. It's so weird. I can't. I know.
Oh, stop it.
It's,
look at what Gabby's done to herself.
I just thought you wouldn't see it if I didn't see the back first.
Looks like you've got the Noah virus.
What have you done there?
I'm bumming James.
You're bumming James. Oh, shit. Okay, so you guys have got a question for us.
Yes.
But ask away, boys.
Right, okay. So on the Bake Off, Paul and Mary look for certain things, both good and bad, when judging our cakes. Can you name three of them?
Paul and Mary's catchphrases, essentially.
I'm really moist.
Weird, having chewed my own face and spat it out, I do actually genuinely look a little bit like Adrian Charles now.
So have you got three of these?
Yeah.
Yeah, we think we've got.
Let's have a look. You guys can be the judge. So, Jack and James, what have you got?
No bakey, no likey. Let the cake see the oven.
Were those Paul and Mary's catchphrases?
No.
Wouldn't it be great if Mary Berry hosted Take Me Out 1 week?
Oh, my God.
Perfect television. Russell, Jonathan?
Crucially, at the top, we've put We Love Brendan.
I love Brendan at the top. Yeah. I put moistness. I think there was a degree of moistness in the sponge. And then we put texture, whether it's risen properly. I know it was snapping biscuits, and then the sweetness and the mix of the sweetness. We didn't get any right, did we? I watched every week, I didn't get one thing right.
What have you got?
Richard, over to you.
That it is a cake. It's their first line of inquiry. Is it a cake? They ask. But if it's not, get out. Can it be held? Because if it can't, I can't eat it. I need to be able to hold this cake. And the last one is just integrity. Do you have integrity?
That is a pretty poor showing. So the answers that you could have had here, you could have had a good wobble, a soggy bottom.
Soggy bottom.
A scrambled eggy texture, a good bake, and of course, crumb structure.
A crumb structure, yeah.
Crumb structure. So crumb. What was the, what got you the win? What was the thing about your final cake?
I had to sleep with Paul Hollywood.
Well, that hasn't really affected the scores massively because you guys didn't get anything. But let's have a quick check. So Jack and James have now got 6 points. You're doing terrifically. Russell and Jonathan, 18. Richard and Gabby way out on the lead with 25 points. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for James, John and Brendan. Time for another quick break now while we all have a slice of cake. See you in a minute. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year 2012. This round is all about the year in science and technology. The International Space Station was resupplied by a private company for the very first time in 2012. The delivery of food, clothes and essentials cost a staggering $1.6 billion. They should have gone to Sainsbury's. Think of the Nectar points. Facebook was floated on the stock market. In the first week of trading, the value of shares plummeted by half, cutting Mark Zuckerberg's personal worth from over $17 billion to just under $14 billion. Loser! We ready for some more questions, I think?
Yeah.
Time for another Say What You See puzzle. What does this one spell?
OK.
I'm good at these.
God Party Granny Disc Sheet.
Jesus. Some people feel tactically an idea not to read them out loud, but...
Jesus balloons.
Floppy.
It's definitely not God Party, is it?
I'm saying
oh,
what I'm
yeah.
It's
fucking
God Party. What are we looking
at? It's time for another guest question, all the way from the forest moon of Endor. It's Warwick Davis.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Hi, Jimmy. In which unusual location would you have been able to find a high-energy laser beam, a nuclear battery, a microchip containing over a million people's names, and Will.i.am's new single?
Wow. Warren wants to know, where could you find a high-energy laser beam, a nuclear battery, a microchip containing over a million people's names, and Will.i.am's new single? Where could you find that eclectic mix of things? In September this year, what was responsible for the disappearance of the Statue of Liberty, the return of Woolworths to the High Street, and the relocation of Luton to the coast?
We are going to catch Gabby up and defeat her now.
For the next question, over to Formula One hero, Jenson Button.
Hey, Jimmy. Hey, everyone. As you probably know, I live a pretty fast and furious life, but I was devastated to hear the news that the slowest and the rarest creature, the giant tortoise from the Galapagos Islands, passed away in June. Can your teams tell me his name?
I know it.
He looks devastated by that news. Absolutely heartbroken.
So, Jenson wants to know the name of the elderly tortoise who died this year.
It was very sad. 100 years old.
This year, a team of scientists from the States released this recording. What is it? It's that simple. Why is that recording?
Sounds like an Oompa Loompa having a kazoo removed from it.
Jack! I cannot believe what he's just written.
I'll admit.
Oh my God! Five,
it's a little bit wrong.
It's a family show.
It's a family show.
Let's get on with the answers.
So I asked you to say what you saw. What did you all get?
God balloons, Mary berries, floppy curtains.
God balloons, Mary berries, floppy curtains. Very so close. Okay, Jonathan, Russell.
We were with them in the beginning, so we got God party call. Then we put floppy sheets. We weren't sure what the ending could be. I don't think we've got it quite right.
Okay, Richard, Gabby.
You do the good bit.
God particle, yeah.
Yeah.
Something.
Disc sheet?
OK, so it's God, party, call, disc, covered.
Covered.
Discovered.
Oh. Higgs boson.
Yeah, God particle discovered. OK, big science news. No points for anyone there. OK, Warwick Davis asked you where you could find a high-energy laser beam, a nuclear battery, a microchip containing over a million people's names, and Will.i.am's new single. Where was it?
Tring.
Tring, yeah.
In Watford. But I bet you've got something different on your card, because that's the way this game's going for us.
OK, Russell, Jonathan?
I thought it was Anthony Wall Thompson's garage. Had the stuff from all over. But we went instead with Sue's anal bum party.
You could not find all of those things at Sue's anal bum
party. Oh, there's the
party.
Capacity, my friend. Don't you worry about that.
OK, Richard, Gabby?
Asda.
You cannot buy a nuclear battery in Asda.
You can.
You can if it's the Asda in Tring.
They do everything. I love Asda. You can buy TV from there, watch it for 2 years and take it back. They don't care. They told me that. The man said, just take it back when you're finished. We don't care here. And true to his word, I took it back after 2 years. His manager cared a lot more than him.
All space.
Yeah.
Well, space is... They were all on board NASA's Curiosity rover, which landed on the surface of Mars earlier this year. So I think you get a point for space.
What's happening?
OK, I ask you, what was responsible for the disappearance of the Statue of Liberty, the return of Woolworths and the relocation of Luton? Correct answer is dynamo.
Thank you very much, James.
Well, trust me. Because we have Derren Brown, and I would argue that Derren was the first and the best.
Dynamo is a better conjurer than Derren Brown.
No way, what are you, mad?
I met Dynamo.
Hang on, whoa! It's like a wizard rap battle.
Yeah. Well, hang on, let's go to Richard and Gabby for their answer before we get the real answer.
What? Look at your card, Jimmy. Don't just stare at me. Look at your card.
It's not right, Russell.
It was the Apple Maps.
Put it on the side.
On the new iPhone.
I can tell you the correct answer is the disastrous launch of Apple Maps' new Maps app because they were too frugal for Google.
They were too frugal for Google.
There was a bloke on the news that we saw that was complaining. Went, he's pointing at his phone and went, it says that my house is in a river and I don't live in a river. It's ridiculous. What if people think I'm a fish? Who gives a shit? It's a phone.
Next up, Jason Button asked you to name that dead giant tortoise.
That sounds like a really weird game show, doesn't it?
Name that giant dead tortoise.
Multiple choice.
Yeah, it's one of these four.
Michelangelo, Donatello, Raphael, or Leonardo.
OK, what did you get?
I have been given the pen this round, and I thought maybe... It was named after Sebastian Coe.
He's the oldest tortoise, so he's more than 100 years old.
Yeah.
But you thought he was named...
Yeah, that was what... That's why I remembered it, because it was so weird. Because it obviously involved a name change once Sebastian Coe became famous for running.
Sebastian Coe was named after the tortoise.
Or it could have been that.
Of course, yeah. Of course.
That parents were kind of ironic. Our son's going to have fast twitch muscle fibres. Let's call him after a very slow tortoise.
I'm so pleased fast twitch muscle fibres is a phrase that has been uttered. I'm so pleased that that's happened. That's tremendous.
Russell, Jonathan?
Lonesome George. He's 100 years old and he never had sex.
He was all alone George. For 100 years.
Well, let's.
That's why he never had sex because he was called Lonesome George.
So Lonesome came later.
Oh.
He was probably christened George.
Well, I just had this image of him kind of, all right, ladies. Oh, fuck, here comes Lonesome.
Were there lady tortoises there?
Yeah, they tried to mate him.
Well, he was the last of his species. He became like a pin-up boy for. There he is. I can see why he didn't get laid.
Oh, my God.
Is he all right, Jensen?
Jensen Button, I think.
Because he seems so upset.
He was distraught.
Absolutely devastated. He loves life in the fast lane. And so it's great that he's taken time out to talk about this.
Lonesome George is the right answer. You get a point, you guys do not get
so
a point.
Right,
okay. Thanks. And finally, I played you a scientific recording. What did you think it was? What do you think this noise was? Let's go to Jack and James.
Is Joe Pasquale getting bummed?
Is the right answer.
Richard and Gabby?
Is it dolphins chatting?
Dolphins chatting. You're close.
We think it's this was a recording of a whale, and the scientist said he was talking, and they thought that they'd caught him making certain noises, which they picked up as certain. I can't remember what language it was. It wasn't English, but there was a language, and they thought he was speaking to them.
He was saying, "I hate Japanese fishermen."
Well, I mean, I can't believe you got this so completely right. It was a whale called Nock that they attempted to teach how to speak human. That is as far as they got. OK, time for another bonus round.
It's a disaster.
Oh, yeah, okay. Here we go.
Another little bonus round. This time it's about virals. Yeah. Have a look at these pictures of some shocked and upset-looking people. What has taken them by surprise? So write down your answers. What do you think they are?
Oh, we've got to write this down, have we? What's going on here? We don't really understand.
Well, that's really the question.
Could you give us a clue?
Well, I think the clue there, look at what they're all wearing, that might be a bit
But it's weird because she's quite amused by it, but the woman's really upset.
They're being filmed as they leave.
I know.
You know
Jonathan, write something down.
Russell knows the answer. He's writing it down.
Of course he is. Okay. So what did you all get for this?
We've got David Beckham in a photo booth, isn't it?
He's right. He's only bloody right.
He's right.
What have you got? You've got.
They've just met Bex.
Okay. And what have you guys got?
Met Beckham at the Olympics.
Let's have a little look.
It's incredible.
Right. Oh. Is that all right?
It's so beautiful, isn't it? I mean, imagine if John Terry had rocked up, how different that would be.
Oh, hello!
It's when the little boy cries, it's so beautiful.
That must be such a burden for David Beckham, though, walking around and people just lose their shit.
You get used to it.
Okay, points all round. Okay, so let's move on. This intrepid German became a viral sensation this year during a cold snap, but how? How did this man become a viral sensation?
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, I did see this. Yeah, yeah.
I mean, dude.
I think.
Okay, have you all got something written down? Okay, let's have a look.
We didn't know what the answer was, so we thought it would be funny instead to write down Jonathan's mobile number on our screen. Like, call him whenever you want.
What did you guys get, Richard, Gabby?
I thought he was, one of those genuinely funny Nazis. And it's difficult, because, you can't condone what they did. When one's funny...
Russell, Jonathan?
It's the we've called him Ice Pool Idiot, but it's the guy that tries to jump into a pool.
Oh, yeah.
Ice!
He tries to go through the ice, he's going to show off to his friends and they're filming him, and then it doesn't quite turn out as expected.
Let's check out this clip.
Michael, fuck the fucking world, and my new band is called Syskill.
In fairness, that was better than Tom Daley's second round dive in the Olympics.
Okay, let's take a quick look at the scores. Jack and James, you've got 7. Russell and Jonathan, you've got 23. You're catching up to Richard and Gabby. They have 27. Okay. We're going to take another quick break, but don't go away. Back in a minute. Welcome back to the final part of the Big Fat Quiz. This round is all about the talking points and water cooler moments that define the year. Europe's tallest skyscraper, the Shard, opened in London. From the top, on a clear day, you can see France, which sort of ruins it for me. A referendum on Scottish independence was announced. Before the vote, David Cameron has insisted Scotland gets a hamster so they can learn about responsibility. Are you ready for your final batch of questions?
Yeah.
It's all to play for. You could definitely catch up, James and Jack.
Come on.
This year, all the cool kids were hashtagging their inspirational tweets with YOLO. But what does YOLO stand for?
We know this.
Yeah, we do.
Okay. What does YOLO stand for?
YOLO. Oh, yeah.
Oh, I've written... Hold it.
I can give you some example of YOLO tweets, if that helps.
Okay. Yeah.
OK. Love to sing. Am I good at it? No. Do I still sing? Duh. Hashtag YOLO. I haven't worn a bra all day. Hashtag YOLO.
Who had YOLO? Someone's had YOLO tattooed on there, hasn't there? Who is it? One of the young American stars has had...
Zac Efron had YOLO tattooed on the side of his hand.
You would think he would know better.
Well, it's an interesting move because a lot of people regret tattoos years after they had them. He can regret that pretty much right away. Yeah. Saves a lot of time. Now we've got a very special treat for you. It's over to the Big Fat Quiz's Masterpiece Theatre where actor Charles Dance is giving us a reading. Oh, yeah. But what is he reading from? Over to you, Charles.
Chapter 2. Let me ask you something first. Do you want a regular vanilla relationship with no kinky fuckery at all? My mouth drops open. Kinky fuckery? A squeak? Yeah, kinky fuckery. I can't believe you said that. Well, I did. Answer me, he says calmly. I flush. My inner goddess is down on bended knee with her hands clasped in supplication, begging me. I like your kinky fuckery, I whisper. Yeah. That's what I thought.
Chucky there. Let's face facts. Chuck D is the man.
He's not reading that, he's memorized that. He didn't look down at that book once.
He's not just memorized it, he's living that.
Okay, how did a 3-year-old ginger cat called Teddy Bear spark a local crisis involving 31 policemen, 2 helicopters, and an armed response unit?
Well, that is a terrific photo, isn't it?
The cat is on the left there.
Yeah.
I mean, how much do you have to love your cat to do that to yourself? Okay, an animal charity in New Zealand hit the headlines after they made a major breakthrough in the training of rescue dogs. What are they taught the dogs to do?
Nice, yeah, put that, yeah.
That's funny. I think we've got 4 right answers here, Jimmy.
I'm crossing it out.
Thank you very much.
Back in the game.
I'm loving your confidence. Okay, ready for some answers?
Yeah.
Okay, I asked you what YOLO stood for. Any guesses?
Yes, O, lobster ominous.
I would be tempted to give you a point for that, but it's so wrong. What have you got, Russell Jonathan?
You only live once, but we've added the new phrase, yoyab, unless you're a Buddhist.
It's a very good point, well made, yeah. Richard, Gabby?
Yeah. You only live once.
You only live once, yeah.
You only live once, although I saw someone tweet saying, you only die once, you live every day, to which I decided to unfollow them.
But it's that thing, isn't it? Like, you know, it's such a crappy phrase. Like, people go, YOLO, man, they never do... It's like you were reading out. They never do profound things, like try and cure cancer or something like that. It's like, I've just done a shit on someone's car. YOLO.
Did you do a shit on my car?
No. But do you mean those pathetic, like, yeah, blood's thick in the water? So's yoghurt. My favourite one is, like, when you hear blokes are going, oh, I shagged her brains out. You know what I mean? It's such a... Surely that would be awkward, wouldn't it? How was that for you?
So, you get a point, you get a point, you do not get a point for lobster ominous. Charles Dance read from you from one of the literary phenomenons of the year. What was it?
We think it was How to Bake by Mary Berry.
What did you put?
We've got Anne Widdecombe, My Life.
Richard, Gabby, you went for?
We're here to play the best quiz we can. We want to take it home.
Richard's book of the year, 50 Shades of Grey.
That is the right answer.
Thank you.
50 Shades of Grey, of course.
It's such a crap title, isn't it, 50 Shades of Grey? It sounds like something you'd find in Philip Schofield's plug hole. But Philip Schofield's plug hole, that is a good title for a filthy book. Do you know, one of the interesting stories is that it had a massive impact on the economy, 50 Shades, because women read it and went out and bought, like, dildos and butt plugs and jiggle balls and all. Generally, it's seriously true.
What's a jiggle ball?
I don't know. He put it out of jiggles. But, so basically, we came out of recession because of the Olympics and 50 Shades of Grey. So we came out of recession because of the Mobot and the mum rub. How lovely is that? But it's true. But that's what got us out of the recession. Wanking mums. You shouldn't feel bad about it. That's wonderful. We wanked our way out of recession. You dirty little heroes. We're back in the green because you flicked your bean. That is wonderful. Absolutely incredible. You should be
fucking saluted.
Yeah,
YOLO! YOLO, you heroes!
OK, I asked you how a three-year-old ginger cat called Teddy Bear sparked a local crisis involving 31 policemen, two helicopters and an armed response unit. Anyone get this?
He was in Wokingham and he held Richard Iowati hostage in the basement for 6 months.
That is not the case?
It's not the case.
What did you go for?
She went apeshit.
A three-year-old ginger cat did not go apeshit.
Cat shit? I mean... I know what you're saying. It's weird because it's a mixed metaphor.
OK. Russell, Jonathan, you got this.
It was the Essex Snoop Dogg, the Essex lion.
Yeah.
They thought it was a lion, didn't they?
So Teddy Bear was a ginger cat mistaken for a lion, giving rise to the Essex lion scare. Here's the picture they took.
It does look quite lion-y. You're a little lion-y.
A little bit, I'll give you that, yeah, a little bit lion-y. I mean, don't call an armed response unit, maybe have a little look.
I'll tell you what, I'll check this out first, just to make sure, before I call anyone else. If you're still convinced it's a lion and you're 6 foot away, something's gone wrong.
Well, if you're 6 foot away and that's what you're seeing, I think your cataract is more of a problem than the lion.
I'm just saying, in a situation where it is a lion, back up.
Also, okay. If you want to kill a lion, you don't call 30 armed police. That's stupid. You lure it into a canyon and then get three hyenas to instigate an antelope stampede.
Yeah.
Hakuna Matata.
Oh, God, I'm crying even thinking about Mufasa. Mufasa, YOLO. OK.
Hakuna Matata, guys. Hakuna Matata.
Hakuna Matata.
And finally, I asked you what a New Zealand charity taught rescue dogs to do. What did you think?
Got this. Be taught to be led by the blind. Switcheroo. Because fuck that, the blind have been taking the piss for so long. It's time that they started leading some dogs around.
Yeah. No. OK, what did you get?
Did they teach them to make calls, 999 calls?
These were rescue dogs, like dogs that you rescue from bad homes, not dogs that rescue you. On the emergency lines.
This is not the story I thought it was.
Don't look at
me. Yeah,
we
got confused by that one as well, Gabby. If we'd have known that, we would have never put that.
No.
It felt like a long shot anyway. Now it looks ridiculous.
Confused.
Oh, Jonathan, Russell, what did you get?
If they're going to rehabilitate these dogs, we think they taught them to make love in the missionary position. To rise above the stigma of the doggy style.
Or...
that's been holding them...
Further, to get their own back as well, they strap Mitt Romney to the roof of the car.
Take a look at this, it's amazing.
Good boy! Yeah.
He knows exactly what to do.
Hey!
Oh, yeah.
Look at
that! Oh. Hey!
Once Marie gives the A good, for wait. Accelerator command, he's off. It's a truly remarkable sight.
Wow. I love the fact he looks so proud of himself.
OK, to finish the show in style, we've got one final big fat question. And to ask it from Team GB and Paralympic GB, it's gold medal winners Sophie Christensen, Natasha Baker, Anna Cockcroft, Ed McKeever, Etienne Stott, Helen Glover, Peter Wilson, and Nicola Adams. Very nice to see you all. How are you? Have you got the medal on? Where's the medal?
I would say I lost it, but that would be a lie. A friend of mine dropped it, so it's gone back to get fixed.
Are you all going on to...
Hopefully.
Not sure.
What do you mean you're not sure?
We haven't decided. Me and my crewmate, Tim, we've yet to sit down and decide fully about it, but it's so tempting. Going to Rio, how cool would that be?
Oh, well, that sounds like a decision made, then. Fine. I mean, so what was the... I mean, obviously, the high point for all of you guys was getting the gold, right?
And the after parties, they were pretty...
They were pretty wicked.
Well, yeah. This is what I heard about the Olympic Village, that the Olympic Village was like Sue's album launch party the whole time. That's what I heard. Was that... Is that...
Absolutely.
No, that was a rumour.
Nicola, would you punch Jimmy for me just to show him? Because he was saying female boxers can't hit hard earlier. He actually said that to me. He seriously said there's no way a female boxer could hurt him with a punch. That's what he actually said to me.
So you've got a big question for us, I believe, for the end of the Big Fat Quiz of the Year. OK, what's your... So the big question, there's... it's in three parts, 2 points for each part, 10 points if you get all three. So 16 points on offer here. Come on.
So what is the most watched YouTube clip of 2012?
What was the highest grossing movie in the UK?
Yeah.
What was the most watched television programme?
That's a tough one.
Let's have a look and see what everyone got. What have you got? Jack,
Gangnam
James?
Style, Submarine by the brilliant Richard Ayoade.
Wow.
And the most watched TV show was either Fresh Meat or League of Their Own Series 6.
Okay, so Jonathan, what did you get on this?
We went for Gangnam Style, okay. I think.
Correct.
We want to win this. We went for Skyfall, and then we went for the Olympics opening ceremony as the most watched show of the year, the most watched
okay.
TV event.
Okay, what did you go for, Richard and Gabby?
The same first two, but we couldn't decide whether it was opening or closing, and we went for closing.
Well, I can reveal that Gabby and Richard have it absolutely right.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, wow.
OK, let's have a look and see how that's affected the scores. So, Jack and James have 9 points. Oh, yay! Russell and Jonathan have 30 points. Richard Ayoade and Gabby Logan are our winners with 45 points. Well done. We got you a trophy and some Big Fat Quiz gold medals. A big thank you to our amazing panel, our special guest, and thanks for watching this at home. This has been the Big Fat Quiz of the Year 2012. Good night!
Gangnam Style.